Hi there everyone, and welcome to the third video in this course. We are going to carry on where we left off on the previous lesson. We are going to keep shaping our dragon's head, and to do this I need to explain two very useful tools. We'll begin with the masks. Masks are tools that are used to block part of the tool, the model, and not to modify it. Only certain parts will be modified without altering the whole thing. To access the masks, hold down Ctrl and the brush will turn yellow. The icon in the brush menu will also be different. Everything will be related to the masks. There are different ways of making masks. We have one that's a circumference, a square, a paintbrush to paint the mask manually, and another to mark the area we want masked and the area we don't. The area we mask will stay black and will be blocked, so we can't edit it. And the white area is where we can make changes. As you can see, while the black part is active, we can only modify the white part. This allows us to add lots of details as well as generate good shapes. It can even be used to create poses for our sculptures. So Ctrl Z and let's take a look at another use for our masks. To erase the mask that we've created, all we have to do is make a mask outside of our tool and make sure that mask isn't touching any part of the model. This way the mask we made will automatically be deleted. So as you see, every type of mask works in its own way, but really they're all the same. They block an area of the model and make it easier to edit. This tool is very useful, as you'll find out the more you use ZBrush. You can also reposition masks. While clicking on and holding the mask, press the spacebar and move the mask onto the model to place it wherever you like. You can also invert the mask selection. This is useful to select small areas like eyes, nails, teeth, and other small details. Like this, we can focus on that area, knowing that the rest won't be affected. To invert the mask, you need to click outside your tool. Bear in mind that any action you want to do with the mask must be done holding down Ctrl. Clicking outside the mask inverts it and makes it easier for us to work on those smaller areas. Another thing we can do is to soften or harden the mask. This is used so that when we paint on the mask, the depth of the model has a softer transition from the masked area to the unmasked area, or the other way around. We can make the transition more abrupt. To soften, simply click on the tool holding down Ctrl, and to harden, we'll use Alt to invert the action. And click on the tool, the same as we do for almost everything in ZBrush. So now we're going to use the mask to try and get the shape of our dragon's neck. To do this, we'll paint the area approximately where we want the neck to go. To erase a part of the mask that we made, we'll use the process I showed you. Paint the mask while holding down Ctrl, but then press the key we used to invert, Alt, at the same time to erase a section of the mask. With the move brush, start to paint the neck, and as you can see, it looks a bit strange. This is because the polygons that make up the head have completely stretched. How can we fix this? We'll fix it with the next tool we're going to explore, the Dynamesh. The Dynamesh is a way to create volumes in ZBrush. It's one of the most common tools. You can find it inside the tool palette. Go to the geometry menu and inside there's another menu called Dynamesh. Inside here, amongst other things, there's the Dynamesh option. This is a tool that reorganizes and creates new topology. The topology of our tool, our model, is what we can see when we select the polyframe, shortcut Shift F. And what it does, it places the geometry more tidily and logically to avoid problems like the one we had for the neck. As you can see, the topology of our model is much more organized compared to the way it was before. Before, the top part of the head made a kind of spiral, and now it's much better. The topology's distance is more or less similar. We can modify the resolution of the Dynamesh so that it generates more or less polygons. The higher the resolution, the more polygons are generated. So for us to make shapes from scratch, we'll start with less polygons, so we can control everything much better. Now the top part of the head looks much better. The spiral has disappeared and all the polygons surrounding the areas of the head are at a similar distance. Once I've pressed Dynamesh once, the icon remains an orange color and it also remains selected. This means that to select Dynamesh again for our model, we don't have to keep selecting it. All we have to do is create a mask outside the tool and the topology will reorganize itself automatically. The mask we've made is too big, and we should go over it again so the neck has a normal appearance. Just Ctrl X to undo and go over the mask again to get the shape you want. Now you see that the shape of the neck is strange again. The polygons have stretched again. We need to use the Dynamesh again. But as I said before, we don't need to click on the icon again. We just need to make a mask outside the model without touching it, and the polygons will reorganize themselves. Lower the resolution of the Dynamesh, and then you can see the result of the topology of the model. Now the neck looks fine. The topology is tidy and logical. Now we can continue working. The Dynamesh tool, as you can see, is very useful. We can make shapes easily without worrying too much about their geometry. As when we stretch our model with the move brush, we can keep on generating polygons and covering everything properly. Now we can work on the autonomy of the dragon's head. Bear in mind that it's a mythical creature, but we can use anatomy of similar existing animals like reptiles or even horses. When you see that you can't get more volume from that number of polygons, increase the resolution of the Dynamesh to generate more polygons. This way you can add more detail to the basic shapes. Soften the model before using the Dynamesh again and start shaping with this new topology. As I mentioned in the previous video, it's important to have a reference or something to base yourself on, to know what kind of shapes you need, so you're not working blind. Gradually, everything will start to take shape, and with time and practice, you'll feel more comfortable using the program. Especially once you've learned all the shortcuts, you'll see that you'll end up with clean designs quickly, without any major problems. Remember to always keep rotating your model, checking how it's coming along from every angle. We don't want any of the sides to look odd. It's also important to bear in mind that although all the polygons are visible on the model, all we're doing is generating volume. It takes many hours of work to achieve a great result. So what we're doing now is constantly making adjustments and rotating the model to get the shapes we need. Also, use the brushes I introduced in the previous video. This will help you get some good shapes. Again, remember that you can use the mask to hide parts of the model and gradually leave things on different levels. For example, in this case, we want the upper jaw to be above the lower one. To do this, we can move the jaw above the other, and with the mask, the lower one won't move. You can use the trim dynamic to harden certain parts. If you use it on one side and then use it on a 90 degrees angle, we can get a right angle on that side, and when we make a corner, we get quite a hardened effect. Now, just as we used move to place the upper jaw, we'll use it again to try and push the lower jaw inwards a little, giving the sensation that one jaw is larger than the other. When you get to this point, the Dynamesh is no longer necessary, as the shapes are more or less the ones we want, and the topology won't really change much more, so we can deactivate it, no problem. Mark the areas where the eyes will go, and this is what we are going to do in the next video, as well as some horns for the head. So you see, we're doing a kind of blocking to see which details we'll use for the final design. I hope you're enjoying the course. I'll see you in the next lesson.